put a cushion layer on the surface of the painting to protect it. After the cushion layers are applied, then we apply what's called a facing. The facing is made up of several layers of paper or also fabric that are applied with more resin so that the surface is protected. Now the main purpose of this is that the surface of the paint or the paint layers, the paint structure is stabilized during the very stressful process. This is an important step when the layers are going to go through a particularly aggressive mural removal processes. Here you can see we're making progress. We've got to make sure that we don't cause damage to the canvas and that we don't stress the paint and cause flaking. Another technique for keeping the painting and the paint layers safe is this large drum that you see. It serves several purposes. One is a take-up roll, or a take-up reel, of course, and the other is to give us a diameter that will not kink the painting and the paint layers while we're removing the mural. The diameter of the tube is very important in helping to keep the painting safe so it doesn't kink and so the paint doesn't get too stressed. But I have seen some murals that have been wound upon a tube this size. And in fact, I'll show you one. These murals were removed in a hurry before a building was demolished, but the result was the same. The stress on the paintings caused these horrible ripples or these stress cracks throughout the painting. They were very lucky to have not set into motion a very insidious, cancerous flaking problem that usually results. This is what the flaking looks like. It comes off in pinpoint spots all over the painting and flakes for decades. The deciding factor on using drums and large tubes and whatever we do to murals, we are guided by the fact that we need to make sure that the paint is protected and that the painting is stressed the least amount possible. So whenever we're working on a mural, we think first and foremost, what can we do to safely remove this mural? The main purpose is to get the mural out and preserve the artwork. So everything that we do is guided. So you see the size of the drums or the tracks, for instance. You can see us here putting this large drum on a track with some bearings. And you'll notice also that all of these murals that you're looking at here have facings on them. All of these things are important for the preservation of the paint and the mural. The wall on this painting, for instance, had cracked, broken, and was coming out as a result of an earthquake. And so we removed this mural, then the wall was repaired, and then the mural was put back on. In this case, what was really important was the exact registration. The mural had to go back exactly the same place, otherwise it wouldn't have coordinated with all the other designs around it on the wall.